Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming. So this is a talk about the Siemens S7 CommPlus protocol. And the work is mainly done by my colleague, Cheng. But he is unfortunately to get a visa in time. So I represent for him here. First, let's see some related work. Dylan had a talk about exploring the Siemens S7 PLC at Black Hat 2011. And the protocol he discussed is the S7-COM. Ralph has a talk about a worm living solely in the PLC last year. And the protocol he discussed is the early version of S7-COM+. Now, this talk is mainly focused on the current version of the S7-COM+, which is encrypted. So what is a PLC? PLC is responsible for process control in industry control system. A PLC contains a CPU, some I/O modules, some communication modules, and some process modules, etc. Now this is a picture of the Siemens PLC. Siemens named his PLC S7 series. The S7-200, 300, and 400 using the S7-COM protocol. S7-1200 V3 using the early version of the S7-COM+ protocol. And the S7-1200 V4 and 1500 using the current version of S7-COM+ protocol, which is encrypted. That's the protocol we are discussing today. To communicate with the PLC, Siemens provides TIA portal software, which can be used to configure and program the Siemens PLC. So there's a problem that it will communicate with the PLC with through network. So there can be the replay attack. One can capture and replay the packets communicated through the PLC and the PC to control the PLC. So let's see the S7-COM+ protocol for detail. First, the TIA portal will send a connection request packet. This packet had been discussed before, so I won't discuss the detail here. Then the PLC will return a connection response packet. There are two parts need to be noticed. I marked it with the red and the pink. And I will explain later. Then the PC will send the connection request the second time to complete the connection. There's two encrypting part, which is important for the protocol. I also marked them with pink and blue rectangle. Also I will explain them later. After that, the connection is built, so the function packet can be sent from the PC to the PLC. This is an example of a packet to stop the PLC. The important part is also marked with a green rectangle here. So I would say that there are some part needed to be noticed, because there are, this part will be used to validate the packet. There must be the right value to go through the validation and execute the function. First, there are two ID, the session ID and the object ID. The session ID was returned from the PLC, and it seemed to be a random date. And the object ID should be sent from the PC. It should be, the object ID is sent from the PLC. It's the random value. And the session ID should be sent from the PC to the PLC to validate the session. It should be the object ID plus plus 128. Then comes the encryption part. Here's the first packet come from the PC to the PLC. It has two parts that need to be encryption. And the bottom one was the encryption part of the function packet. There's only one part, which is encrypted. And I will explain how they are created. First is the first encryption part of the connection packet. The input is the random value that come from the PLC through the connection responsible packet. And the encryption is just a simple XOR. Now you can see this is the value come from the packet of the connection response packet. And this is the encryption function. It's just a simple XOR. And the result is the first encryption, which is used in the second encryption. Now this is the second encryption part. It uses a private algorithm to do this encryption. So you can see this is the first encryption part, which is calculated from the XOR. And this is the second encryption function. It's a complicated private algorithm, but it can be reverse engineering from the TIA software. So this function was used to encryption, and we get the second encryption part. Now is the function packet encryption part. It uses a fixed field array with the session ID as the input. And also, private algorithm is used to calculate the encryption result. So you can see this is the constant array with the session ID. And this is the encryption function, which is a private algorithm. And this is the result, which can be seen in the function packet. So with all this, we can get a whole map with the communication. The first three packets was the TCP connection, and then the PC sends the connection request packet, and the PLC return the connection responsible packet. And then the second connection request packet. After that, the connection of S7-CommPlus protocol is established. So the PC can send the function packet and do the control work. Now we can see a demo. Now you can see there is a Siemens S7 PLC, a hub and a PC. The PC and the PLC is connecting through the hub. Now here is a program we make to control the PLC. First, we click the connection button and to establish the connection. Through the Wireshark, you can see the connection is established. And the information of the PLC is returned. Now the light is green, means that the PLC is running now. We click the stop button to stop the PLC. The light turns to yellow, means that the PLC has stopped. And then we click the run button to run the PLC again. You can see the light return to green now, means that the PLC is running again. Okay, let's return to the slide. Finally, we'll give some protection suggest. First, from the coding level, we think the Siemens S7 CommPlus protocol uses some private algorithm to make the encryption secret is not a good idea. It uses some. It should use some really encryption algorithm to do this work. And next, in the design level, the And in the design level, they should choose some encryption algorithm like ISA or something like to do the encryption. Finally, in the protocol level, the whole packet should be encrypted and not just some key part of the packet. That's all. Thank you.